Nobody on the left knows anything about politics. They know you're evil. That's it. They know you're a racist, sexist, bigot, homophobe who hates the poor. Right? That's what they know about you. And it's not they think that about you. They know that about you. Deep down, they know all these evil things about you, which is why Thanksgiving dinners are always so awkward if you're unfortunate to have Jewish relatives or you have friends on the left, which are the exact same focus group. The answer to all of this is to speak in the language of morality. This is why I never say the government compels people to do stuff. The government does not compel people to do stuff. The government compels people to do stuff at point of gun. Why do I say that? Because leftists are scared of guns. Right? When you say the government compels things, people say, oh, well, compulsion. Well, that's just like taxes, right? No. That's somebody coming to your house in the middle of the night with a SWAT team, with a gun, pointing it at you and dragging you off to prison for not doing what they want. Right? That is what we are facing. Right? When it comes to the left, it's not when we're such idiots, honestly. We were constantly arguing about whether our tax program is more efficient than their tax program. It's not about efficiency. Barack Obama gave the right answer to the wrong question, right? When he was asked in 2008, would you raise the capital gains tax, even if it means less revenue to the government? Would you raise it? He said, yes, for purposes of fairness. Right? Even if it meant people were more impoverished, even if it meant people were more poor, the answer was yes, for purposes of fairness. Why? Because people don't speak the language of poverty. People don't speak the language of efficiency. People don't speak Mitt Romney's 57-point tax plan. You can't even name 2 points on his 57-point tax plan. People speak the language of fairness and justice and morality. They want to think that they are right and the other guy is wrong. They want to have a feeling of, in many cases, unearned moral superiority based on their opposition to things. This is why everybody was getting off ripping on Donald Sterling for being a crazy old racist coot. Did they accomplish anything? No. But they felt real good because they got to go around telling all their friends that Donald Sterling was a racist old coot. Right? This is what they do. So, speak their language. In other words, next time they say something like, I believe in the minimum wage, then you should say, why exactly is it that you want to put a gun to the head of a business owner and force them to pay something? Why is that okay? Why isn't that violative of basic principles of consent? Like you over here, you like gay marriage because you say that two men should be able to wed each other, but those two men shouldn't be able to do business with each other in a mutually agreed relationship. So if instead of them having sex, they were actually just, one was signing a check to the other to paint his car, then you're saying that's not okay? And that you're going to take a gun and put it to the head of one of them in order to make that happen? It's because you're a totalitarian, right? This is the truth. The left is totalitarian. You don't have to feel bad about saying these things. And when you talk about the inefficiencies of the left's social policies in the inner city, who gives a crap? This is it, really. I mean, honestly, that no one in the inner city is thinking about, wow, this really is not very efficient. What they're thinking is there are a bunch of Tea Party Ku Klux Klanners out there who are going to invade their inner city and burn down their houses. Why do they think that? Because they're Democrats and apparently some Republicans, Dad Cochran, who actually have been doing this sort of stuff, have been saying this sort of stuff. The answer to that is that the real racists are and always have been folks on the left who wish to exploit racial division in order to pay off their cronies. The reason the education system sucks in the inner city is because the left wants to pay off its union buddies at the expense of black kids. The reason that the left has not done anything for the inner cities despite years of dominance in Detroit, the reason is because they wanted the violence. And it is about intent. It's not about effect. There's a really telling point in the 2012 election cycle when Bill Clinton was talking about Obama, and he said, the difference between Obama and Mitt Romney is that Romney is somebody who says that Barack Obama's done a really poor job. Barack knows he hasn't done a great job, but he feels really bad about it. This was an actual line, right? And people bought that because, and the polls show this, right? 80% of people thought that Mitt Romney cared less about them than Barack Obama in exit polls. 80%. That's a majority of Republicans. Right? But when it came to policies, they agreed with Mitt Romney. But people don't vote with their heads. People vote with their hearts. So go after what people feel. Go after the language of morality. Socialism is not a good idea that went wrong. And whenever you hear Republicans or conservatives say this, it's because they have the IQ of a kumquat. Socialism was a horribly evil idea that went completely right. It went exactly as they thought it was going to go. This was the design from the start. Socialism is a fundamentally immoral, evil, unfair, discriminatory, and disgusting system that violates off the bat three of the Ten Commandments, right? You don't steal, God, not government, and you shouldn't be jealous of your neighbor's ass, right? That's the in the actual language, correct?
Yes.
Not the Bill Clinton language. So these are the terms that we should be speaking. These are the terms that hit young people. Because young people, nobody has the time to read all of the entire editorial page of the Wall Street Journal. Nobody does. Everybody's attention span is 5 seconds long. So if you can't make people feel good about being conservative, make them feel really, really bad about being leftist. You know why? They deserve to feel bad about being leftist. They're siding with an evil ideology.